Morning. Whether you're joining us here in the church or whether you're on our social media, we hope you enjoy our service and welcome to the First United Church of East Syracuse. We're going to welcome the Reverend Alan Kinney this morning, who will be our guest pastor, and we're glad to have him. Also, happy Mother's Day to everybody out there. Thank you. I have a few announcements. This coming Saturday, the church bazaar is from 10 to 2, and there's also a bake sale. I know they're still probably looking for bakers, so if you want to bake, let Gladys know or Sue, and I hope everybody shows up. We got like 29 vendors, I think, that are going to be having their wares here to sell, so hopefully, and it'll come and make some money for the church. Next Sunday after service, there's a dedication of the accessible parking spaces in the memory of Linda Polcaro out front where they put all the new things in. So that will be after church on Sunday. Hopefully the weather will be as nice as it is today. Also next Sunday, is it Diane, are you going to be doing the poppies? Should the poppies available in the narthex for anyone who would like to take one? The 20th is Armed Forces Day, so we're doing it obviously on the 21st. Donations are appreciated, but not required. Also, Baccalaureate Sunday is going to be June 11th, and we did approve it at Parish Council. So it says on the approval of Parish Council, I'm pretty sure we approved it. And if you have anybody that's graduating, please let Dale know or send an email to the church or let just let one of us know and so we can get the names and a gift for them. Next Saturday after our bazaar, the Collamer Church is having their monthly chicken and biscuit dinner. It's 4:30 till gone, and it's cash only. And it was what, 13 for adults and 10 for children? Is that what? Six for children. So hope we'll support them also. Oh yeah, it's a drive-through. Yeah, you're right, drive-through. Does anybody else have any other announcements? I don't know if everybody heard Dale at home, but there's an estate sale. It's your mother-in-law? Yeah. 105 Irving? East Irving in East Syracuse. And next Saturday, that also, it's a busy next Saturday, I guess. Anybody else? As is our custom each week, we light the candles of remembrance and the candle of peace. The candle of remembrance is lit for those in the military, their families, veterans, first responders, and all those in harm's way. The candle of peace reminds us to pray for God's peace in our homes, community, nation, and the world. If you'll rise as you're able and join us in the call to worship. May the peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with your spirit.
Let us throw open the gates of our hearts that the Spirit of God may enter. Let us lift our voices in praise of God this and every day.
Let us rejoice and sing praise to the Lord.
Our first hymn this morning, This is a Day of New Beginnings, number 383.
Thank you.
Now, if you'll join in the prayer of confession. Almighty God, of all people and all ages, we come together today to hear your word and to respond to your call upon us. We have not always been a faithful people. We have listened to our own desires and not to your call to us. We have sought the path of ease when you have called us to serve. We have become deaf to your voice and hear the voices calling us to serve the deities we have created. Forgive us and hear us as we pray the prayer your Son taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Our first reading this morning is a responsive psalm. It's Psalm number 63, and it'll be found on page 788 in your hymnal. O God, you are my God, I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh faints for you. And in a dry and weary land where no water is. So I have looked upon you in the sanctuary, beholding your power and glory. Because your steadfast love is better than life, my lips will praise you. So I bless you as long as I live. I will lift up my hands and call on your name. My soul is feasted as with marrow and fat, and my mouth praises you with joyful lips. When I think of you upon my bed and meditate on you in the watches of the night. For you have been my help, and in the shadow of your wings I sing for joy. My soul clings to you. Your right hand upholds me. But those who seek to destroy my life shall go down into the depths of the earth. They shall be given over to the power of the sword. They shall be prey for jackals. But the king shall rejoice in God. And all who swear in God's name shall glory. But the mouths of liars will be stopped. Our next hymn this morning is, Lord, You Have Come to the Lakeshore. Number 344.
Thank you. The gospel lesson this morning comes from the Gospel of John, the 14th chapter, verses 15 through 21. Jesus is speaking to the disciples. He said, "If you love me, you'll keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, for he abides with you, and he will be in you. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live. On that day, you will know that I am in my Father, and you are in me. They who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me. And those who love me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and reveal myself to them." This is the word of God for the people of God. It's good to be with you this morning. The trustees asked me to make a very brief announcement. It appears the pews in the back are wearing a lot quicker. They're brand new up here. Went to a Mets game. You know how much I had to pay for front seats on the third baseline? Up in the cheap seats. It was the cheap seats. Anyway, enough of that. It's very nice to be with you on this special day. Many years ago, when I was beginning ministry in a very small town called Clockville, a older clergy came by my side and we became friends, and his friendship and his wisdom proved to be invaluable. And one spring day he asked me, "Alan, are you celebrating all three of the high holy days for the church?" I said, "Al, what do you mean? I know about Christmas and Easter," and I had just gotten out of seminary. I thought I knew them all. He said, "How about Mother's Day?" And we laughed, but there was a lot of wisdom in his words then as they are now. I must admit, the celebration of Mother's Day in the local church has truly changed just in the short time that I've served as clergy. We used to celebrate by honoring the oldest mother that was there on Mother's Day Sunday. We used to honor the mother who had the most children and probably filled the Sunday school, and it was there that Sunday. We used to celebrate the youngest mother, but then mothers started being 15 and 14, and the church said, "We really shouldn't honor that." And looking back on that, I question that wisdom. Who should we honor more than a young person who's decided to go ahead and become a parent? What type of path lay before them? What was there in their lives that lay before them that the blessing of the church wouldn't be even perhaps more needed? I never professed that from a pulpit before. But today, let us honor, and may we celebrate a happy and joy-filled Mother's Day for all who are mothers or who fill that role as a mother, no matter your gender or your identity. May we celebrate all those who are caring. I remember a little while ago preaching on a Mother's Day, and afterwards a wonderful member came up and said, "Don't ever, ever preach that sermon again, please." Turns out her mother was abusive, was an alcoholic, was far from a picture of what we might consider ideal motherhood. And so I never have. And yet, there's a need for people who care. a need for people who love. I wish I could somehow communicate to my mom and my dad how grateful I am and how sorry I am for what I put them through, which I'm not going to confess to you this morning. My brother was the worst one. He was born first. My folks said, we can do better. They had me and said, yeah, that's perfection. Let's stop. But I wish I could somehow say I'm sorry for some of the stuff I did and the worries and the pain I must have put them through to any person who is a mother or, as I said, fills that role. Bless you. May we give our thanks. There's never enough within you, and it is appreciated. Today's gospel lesson is the continuation of the lectionary reading from last week. It appears to be reassuring the followers that even though Jesus may be gone, they will not be deserted. In the 13th chapter, just one before, Jesus predicted that one of the disciples would betray him and one would deny him. Can you imagine sitting about and hearing him say something like that? My inclination would be, is it me? Or, yeah, I know who it is. It had to be frightening. The reading this morning begins with, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments, and I will pray the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, for it neither sees him nor knows him. In preparing for today, that struck me rather odd. If you keep my commandment, what was the commandment Jesus gave? I thought first, okay, Matthew. When the scribes came to him and said, what is the greatest commandment? Jesus said, you shall love your Lord, your God, with all your mind, all your heart, all your soul. And the second is like the first. You shall love your neighbor as you love yourself. That almost made sense. Matthew was written some 50 years before the Gospel of John. He could have used that as the commandment, but it didn't settle well. I wanted to look a little bit more. And so, I'm ashamed, I did look more, and just the chapter before today's, Jesus gives them a commandment. He said, I give you a new commandment, that you love one another just as I have loved you. You also should love one another. So that just might be the commandment Jesus is speaking about. If you love me, you'll keep my commandment. But what does that mean for us? If you love me, you'll keep my commandment that you love one another even as I have loved you. He loved a group of which one of them was going to betray him, one of them was going to deny him. One was a tax collector, one was a lawyer, but he loved them, not because they were perfect. My parents loved me. Believe me, not because I was perfect, but they loved. So how do we celebrate that today? No parent is perfect. No child is perfect. How do we live into that? If we look at organizations, we all want to appear, all organization, as if we're healthy, as if we get along, We all have the appearance on the outside of harmony and fellowship. But my mom's words come to me. Not everything is as it appears. How many organizations beneath the surface, it's not so peaceful. It's not so harmonious when they get away from each other. Do you know what that guy said the other day? When we get out and the committees of the parking lot start to form, how well do we live into the phrase, if you love me, you'll keep my commandment. My commandment, you shall love one another even as I have loved you. I consider that, and that stupefies me. How could Jesus love people that would betray, that would lie, that would deny, that weren't as perfect as we are in church? How could he love them? And yet we're called, if you love me, you'll keep my commandment. That's tough. Because people don't always agree with me. And they should, because I'm right. I went to seminary. I know that stuff. I listened to my stepson who went to seminary yesterday. He didn't go yesterday. I listened to him yesterday. And inside, I can't repeat what I thought. It's like, man, Ben, you're so wrong. What are you thinking? But I was smiling and just kind of nodding, not because I was falling asleep, because it was like the little feet on the duck under the water, just kind of going like this. You know, what are you thinking? Is that how you love one another? Listening, not trying to form a reply, but listening to learn what the other person is saying. That's hard listening. That's real hard. But it leads to understanding. As a church, we don't agree on everything. And if we listen to other people we don't agree with without trying to form a response, we just might learn a little bit more. That we as a group are so much wiser than me as an individual. That we as a people who don't always agree are moving on to perfection. We're moving on. We are not the church we were 50 years ago or 60 years ago. The church today is a different church than what I was ordained into. Right over in Hendricks Chapel, Bishop Yackel put his hands on my head and whispered the magic words that all the elders hear. In my case, it was, you're lucky. A grand man, and he didn't say that. But if we listen to those around us without judging, but hearing, not just the words, but hearing what's being said, perhaps we're starting to love as Jesus loved. And perhaps we then start to move forward, moving on to perfection. Will you pray with me? Almighty God, help us to be more Christ-like in our living, in our speaking, in our listening. May we become the people that you have created us to be. In Christ's name I ask. Amen.
if you're here in the sanctuary, you can leave your tithes and offerings in the basket in the narthex as you exit after the service, or if you're at home, you can mail them to the church at 823 Franklin Park Drive.
Lord God, our Creator, we joyfully present to you our tithes and offerings. We know the privilege of being sheep of your pasture. We know that everything is at your disposal, and you are not dependent on us. Nevertheless, please receive this humble offering that we give with great delight. It is our desire to honor you, our
Now comes the time of joys and concerns, and I imagine Paul's getting the microphone all ready to walk around.
Yes, I would like to ask for some prayers for Roxanne. She doesn't seem to be holding her food down, so she has some stomach issues. I think it could be the medicine. I don't know. So just keep her in your prayers. Thank you.
Just a friendly reminder that, as you know, on this coming Saturday, if you have any baked goods or you haven't signed up, please do so, because if you're not signing up, I do not know what you're going to be bringing, and I'm going to be baking like crazy. Also, if you want to bring in your stuff early, you can do it on, like, on Thursday. Leave it down in the kitchen. Make sure it's covered. Also, Darlene's text me, because she's not here today, that she's going to be in on Friday to tape and move tables, so if anybody wants to come in and help that day, that's perfectly fine. We'll probably be here for a while, so if you have baked goods or anything like that, please bring it that day. If you're going to be working or anything to help us, vendors sometimes arrive as early as 8 o'clock in the morning to be set up by at least 10. So if you're going to be here to help, please be here by at least 9:30. All right, thank you. Oh, and the food allergies, please label. And wrap individually. If you want to do cookies like four, make sure they're wrapped four. We found out that because there's a variety of individuality with the cookies being wrapped, people have a tendency to take more. What time Friday? Anytime after 9 o'clock, if you want to pop in to see how we're doing.
Just would like to speak for a second here. Please remember, I have a good friend of mine whose son is very ill, and if you would keep him and his and her into his prayers, we'd appreciate it. Also, I'll be leaving next Sunday for Montier Falls, where I'll be at a chaplain conference for 4 days. So be thinking of me. It's going to be very busy. And then also this Thursday, I'll be downtown speaking for all the firefighters that passed this last year.
Let us join together in a time of prayer. Almighty God, you who know our thoughts even before we're aware of them, be with those who have served in the fire service, in the ambulance, those who have volunteered their time and so much of their lives. Be with those who we lifted up in need of healing, with those who continue to fight cancer. May we be all that you created us to become. May we care without asking. For this, in Christ's name, I ask. Amen. Thank you. And now may the peace of the Lord be with you wherever he may send you. May he guide you through the wilderness and protect you from the storm. May he bring you home rejoicing once again unto his doors. Go now in peace.